So the pattern I'm using on the bottle is this, and I will see that which part of the pattern is repeating itself. I can see that this part is repeating itself to have this pattern, and I will further divide into different portions. I can see that this part is repeating itself to have this thing, and if I divide into further parts, I can see that this part is used to make this thing. I will apply mirror modifier on this thing to get this, and further apply mirror modifier to get this thing. First, I will upload my reference images. Press Alt R. I will use a plane. Press RX 90 and scale it to match this thing. Now I will use the knife tool and I'll get this pattern. I will decrease down the opacity of the image to see things a little bit clear. I will apply the material to this plane. Just color of your choice. I will leave it as blue and apply another material. Now I will select the white parts and apply this color. Now I will select this colored part and insert faces and press B and insert a little bit and insert again, just okay. Now we want these parts a sharp edge, like if I show you the image, these parts, these corners are sharp. So let's do this. Now we have sharpened the corner by adding extra edges around the corners. Now let's solve a few things. Just select the parts that I'm selecting. And apply new color. Now I will apply the middle modifier. On X and Y axis. And check on the clipping. So I will duplicate using Shift plus D button just for backup. I will switch off the mirror modifier and I just want to a little bit of roundness at the corner. So I will select these edges and slide. Alright, so I will select these edges and slide by pressing double G. And same thing with the other corners. So, alright, this is the model we have. We have softened the corners a little bit, as you can see. Now I will apply another mirror modifier. And I will add an empty plane axis and set mirror object to this empty. And if I select this empty and now move upwards and downwards, you can see that we have our repeating pattern. And now I'm going to apply these mirror modifier. The points are not connected, so I will select all. This time I'm going to increase the merge distance and I'll get removed 37 vertices. So let's check. Okay, let me select this side and press S, X and 0 to straighten that line. Now I will apply a rear modifier. And select merge. And I will increase my subdivision level just to check. And I think it's fine. I'm getting my pattern. I will decrease the level of subdivision for now. I will select the object and move a little bit. I have added an empty plane axis. And set object offset and select this empty plane axis. Select the plane, the object, the pattern, Control A. Or transform. Now select the empty plane axis, rotate along Z axis a little. Increase the numbers. I want this. I want 10. So I will select the plate and add count to 10. Now the angle will be 36, and I will select the plane, go to edit mode, select and move towards the origin. I have found the circular shape, but it is not a perfect circle, and as if I move towards the origin, it merges because we have on the merge option, but it's not a perfect circle. So how to solve this? Now for the circle position, I will first bend this around the Z axis like that, so we can have circular position. So for this, I will apply a simple deform and I will place it upward and I will select the bend. I have another empty axis which is placed at the origin, and I will select my pattern and go to the edit mode. And here you can see I will turn off my array modifier for now, just to show you the simple deform, and we are on bend. It is bending like that, but I want it on Z axis like that. And the second thing is that empty axis, plane axis bend is placed in the center of this pattern. I just said before that it was on origin. It was not on origin. It is in the center of this pattern mesh. Okay. So I will bend it like, for example, 33 degrees. And I think it's enough. I will change the value if I want to, and I will turn on my array modifier, and I will just move a little bit in the other direction. As you can see there, so we will just meet at a point when it merges, like that point. Okay, go back to the object mode, and for the more circular shape, it's circular, but I will add a circle and give its vertices around about, you can say, 64, and increase the size just to match this point. Move upward a little bit, I will increase the number of vertices by right click, subdivide, and along 5 is enough. And I will exclude sorry. I will extrude down like that. Shit, smooth. And apply a subdivision. I'm just forming the circle so that we can shrink wrap the vertices or points of this pattern onto this cylinder, so we can have a perfect circular shape. So for this, I will apply subdivision modifier to the cylinder. Oh, I just forgot. I will select the vertices and circular, and for the bottom as well, because we have added points by subdividing it. So now it's perfectly smooth and circular. Okay, now moving back to the pattern. We have to scale the circle just it touches the pattern. I can see here that it touches the pattern. And for now, I hide the cylinder and go back to my pattern. I will turn off the modifiers. And now, if I go to the, I will select the faces with the that are colored white. Okay, so the easy thing you can select by going to the material and color one and select. Okay, it will select all the vertices in white color assigned to them. And I will add a vertex group like circle. I have already added the vertex group, so for you I will do it again and click assign. Okay, now if I click on select, it will select the vertices that are colored white. And I have already this in my vertex group, so I will remove it. Okay. So moving back to the modifiers, I will switch on my simple deform modifier, array modifier, and I will also unhide the cylinder. I go back to this point and I will add a shrink wrap modifier and place it after simple deform. Select the cylindrical object. Okay, and now from here, vertex group, select that vertex group just we have created. And you can see that if I turn off my circle, it's a perfect circle. You can see the difference. That now it's in circular shape. If I move towards, switch on and off, you can see that it is in circular shape. Okay. Now I will add another array modifier. Add relative offset and Z1 and how much you want. I think 6 is enough. I 5 would be enough. Okay. Now I want to give a shape like circular, a little bit like that, or you can say something. My drawing is very bad, like some kind of that. So for this, I will add lattice and scale it. Just to make sure the cylinder fits inside. As you can see from the other side, it fits inside this lattice. And go to the pattern. Add lattice modify and select object this lattice. Okay, now select lattice and go to the lattice properties and add 8 to the W and 3 to the V and 3 to the U. Go to the edit mode and select all the points and select, we have to scale, but press S and then press Shift Z to scale it along only X and Y axis. As you can see, I think that's good enough. I'm satisfied with this shape. I'll hide the lattice and let's see. Okay. Now I will apply the modifiers. Accept subdivision. Now I will add the cap of this bottle. We will add a circle. Subdivision modifier, share it smooth, and I will set this. similarly, we will close the bottom of this bottle with another circle. Scale. Solidify to give a little bit of thickness before subdivision.